lawsuits alleging.
New Jersey County, ACLU, of the settlement. Of the 2020 Minneapolis unrest. As head of the union, he played a central role in deciding police policy. The settlement prohibits Kroll from serving as a police officer in three counties for the next 10 years, including Hennepin, Ramsey, and Anoka. Kroll retired from the union in 2021. Minnesota's top political leaders could be getting some wage increases.
And while Governor Walz has already said he'll decline the pay raise, many others see more than 15% increases in compensation over the next 2 years.
Cody Godfrey is at the State Department of Forest tonight, and Courtney, not everyone is on board with the idea of pay raises for lawmakers.
That's right, Randy. A bipartisan council recommended the wage increases, saying salaries have lagged behind cost of living increases for far too long.
It is not a job that you come to because you're trying to make money, but it shouldn't be the case that you can only do this work if you're independently wealthy.
Pay bumps are likely on the way for Minnesota's top political leaders, with the Bipartisan Compensation Council recommending Governor Walz, along with some of the state's top public office holders, receive a 16.5% wage increase over the next 2 years.
I believe, and my colleagues believe, that we should compensate people for the hard work that they're doing.
In a letter sent to legislative leaders last week, the council said the raise is long overdue. The governor and other constitutional officers have only had a salary increase once in the last 20 years. But Republican leaders say they want to see relief for everyday Minnesotans first.
Give some relief back to taxpayers, and after that, let's talk about what we can do with the rest.
A spokesperson for the governor says he will be declining the raise, saying in a statement, because the governor appoints members of the council and would sign the bill, he would not take this salary increase. His decision coming 1 week after news of a taxpayer-funded $17,000 a month rental on Sunfish Lake drew uproar. The governor and his family having to relocate due to a massive renovation project on the governor's mansion in St. Paul.
Is there a spending spree? It's one-party control.
But many say if wages don't increase, no one will want the job.
We want bright, committed Minnesotans to fill these spaces. And salary does play a part depending on where you are in your life.
When compared to the rest of the country, Minnesota ranks 37th in gubernatorial pay. Governor Walz currently bringing home $127,000 a year. Reporting live in St. Paul tonight, Courtney Godfrey, Fox 9. All right, thank you, Courtney. Well, in northern Minnesota, the school district is faced with a difficult decision that's closing a school. And one option for parents would be sending their children to school that's 100 miles away.
Our Rep. Santos explains why the future of that K-12 school is now in jeopardy.
These photos from a freezing last night in northern Minnesota captured the emotions of what's on the line for many families near our border with Canada. After last month, when four of six school board members in the South Cochise Rainy River School District voted to close K-12 school in this next year. Indus is one of two schools in their rural, isolated, and spread-out school district. But now, with its future in question because of significant budget shortfalls brought on by declining enrollment, just over 100 students may be sent to the district's other school, north for some more than 100 miles away.
I live approximately 2 hours away from the Northwood school. So that means I would commute 4 hours a day to go there.
Class president and fourth-generation Indus student Abby Asparkin was at Monday's hearing.
All the emotions, anger, sadness, all at once just hit me.
In this move, teachers with seniority could keep jobs at the district's other school. But Torrin Olson, who's been with the district since 1995, likely would lose his.
Between the two schools, 82 miles separately from one school to the other school.
Students also have the option to open enroll in other districts closer by. But for many, both options are still at least an hour drive. State Senator Grant Hochschild heard all of these concerns before writing this letter.
I am trying to do it with my legislative ability to try to get the funding that we can to this area to see if we can keep this school open.
Funding, Hochschild says, totaling almost $1,000 per pupil.
What we ask the school board is to hold off on their decision to close Indus until they know more about the funding that's going to be coming from the legislature in mid-May.
Now families hope the district will listen and walk back its decision at a meeting next week. Fox 9 reached out to District 363's board chair, vice chair, clerk, superintendent, and principal, but they did not respond to our call. Bev Sanders, Fox 9.
Declining enrollment.
You're in a tough spot, yeah, and a very rural area where kids do have to travel already a great distance.
Next year at 9, NATO has a new order.